On the fateful day of April 14, 1912, the RMS Titanic, a luxury passenger ship described as unsinkable, collided with an iceberg, causing an accident of catastrophic proportions. Hundreds of lives were lost, accompanied by a massive loss of property. After the accident, experts across the world examined the event with surgical precision. Several hypotheses were made as to what could have been done to minimize the losses caused by the collision. One opinion stated that if the Titanic had collided head-on with the iceberg, the damage to life and property could have been greatly reduced. In such a case, if the ship had collision bulkheads in the bow, it would most likely have survived the damage. Moreover, the impact would have flooded the first three, or perhaps four, watertight compartments. As the Titanic was designed to remain afloat with four watertight compartments compromised, the catastrophic loss of life could have been avoided. Those who agree with this head-on hypothesis blame First Officer Murdoch for his irresponsible actions. The Titanic, a 55,000-ton ship, was traveling at 22 knots, about 41 kilometers per hour. Upon sighting the iceberg, they began to steer the ship to the left to avoid a direct collision, but the collision still occurred, and the iceberg scraped along the side of the ship, tearing the hull apart. In defense of Murdoch, there are some problems with the head-on theory. The collision bulkheads on the bow of the Titanic were designed to survive a collision with another ship, but not an iceberg. The compartments of such bulkheads were basically like the crumple zones of modern vehicles, meaning that they absorbed most of the energy of a collision. The same thing would happen with the other ship, as it would also absorb some of the energy of the impact. In such a case, both the vessels would sustain heavy damage, but would likely still stay afloat. If the Titanic had collided head-on with the iceberg, most of the energy of the impact would have been absorbed by the ship, which would have made matters even worse. The ship would have come to a halt almost immediately. Now, just think of how it feels when you're forced to slam on the brakes while driving. An abrupt stop on the Titanic would have thrown people around violently, and since it was night and most passengers were asleep, they would have had no chance of bracing against the impact. The fate of the workers at the front of the ship would have been even worse. In the event of a frontal collision, the impact would have extended through the entire length of the ship, splitting seams and bursting rivets, causing even more of the ship's compartments to flood, causing the ship to sink much faster. Thus, the idea that the ship would have survived if it had crashed head-on into the iceberg is entirely untrue. There have been other suggestions of scenarios in which the destruction could have been minimized, but charging headlong into the iceberg definitely isn't one of them.